Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to talk about the ongoing investigation searching for Naya Rivera and possible hauntings and things like that. So if that interests you, make sure you subscribe to my channel and keep on watching. So Naya Rivera was a Glee actress and celebrity. On Wednesday the 8th, she rented a pontoon boat for her and her four-year-old son at Lake Piro in California. If I said that wrong, don't come for me. I'm not perfect. When they found her son, he was sleeping on the boat and he told authorities that his mom had jumped off and never came back up, which is just so heartbreaking, so devastating. I can't even imagine how terrified he was. The authorities stopped searching for her that Wednesday night because nightfall, and then they picked it back up the Thursday morning. As of now, of me recording this video, she has not been found. She's still missing. Authorities did find her car in the boater rental parking lot. The reason the officials started searching for the boat is because after it hadn't been returned, that's when they went to go look for it. So Naya actually put up a picture of herself on Instagram right before this event happened, and it said, "No matter the year, circumstance, or strifes, every day you're alive is a blessing. Make the most of today, and every day you are given, tomorrow is not promised." Few hours before this all happened, she put up a picture of herself kissing her son, saying, "Just the two of us." Now, it's said that Lake Piro, it's notorious for drownings. The reason is because of rip currents, it's extremely cold, and it's known for its sudden huge waves. It has a 1,200-acre reservoir and a 12-mile shoreline, which makes it just as dangerous as the ocean. It's said that some shows are actually cursed. So for instance, they said The Exorcist, a lot of bad things has happened to cast members around that movie. It's said that SNL has been cursed with a lot of tragedy happening around that show. And it's been a topic for a really long time that Glee has been cursed. So as you guys probably know, Corey Monteith died of a drug overdose. Mark Salling had criminal charges before his suicide. Nancy Motz committed suicide, which is Julia Roberts' half-sister. Jim Fuller died in his sleep unexpectedly. Becca Tobin's boyfriend was found dead in a hotel room. Jesse Luken crashed his car. And then, of course, all the accusations around Lea Michele and how she made everybody's time there absolutely hell. Now, in 2009, the family of Denise Arenado, which she was a 9-year-old girl who went to Lake Piro and drowned, her family actually sued them for $12 million. Wrongful death claim against the owner, the United Water Conservation District. Now, the claim alleges the district knew that the lake was unsafe and there was no postings that said no swimming. There was nothing around to warn people of the crazy drop-off and the unidentifiable water cliffs. It's said too that the family went to swim in this area because the employees told her to. The employees at the lake suggested them to go and to swim. So it's good to know that she was only 50 yards offshore and she was actually swimming in the area that is the lake's day use. Now, here's some eerie, like, haunted facts. Lake Piro and Pyramid Lake, it's about 56 miles away. So people will hike from Lake Piro to Pyramid Lake. A Pyramid Lake is a reservoir that was formed by Pyramid Dam on Piro Creek. Again, it offers boating, jet skiing, fishing, things like that, except for it has a big history with hauntings and things like that. So these two lakes, you could either hike to one or you could take like a jet ski to one. So they just flow into each other. Now, it's said that every springtime, a lot of bizarre events happen where fishermen that go out on these waters never return home. And countless people recall hearing the cries of lost water babies. Locals have two legends that are most commonly told by people who live there. Well, I'm gonna read them to you. The first one is water babies, and it begins with the American Indian Pituit tribe who were said to have thrown malformed and premature babies, it makes me sad, into the dark and murky waters to drown in an effort to keep the tribe strong, keeping only children who would grow to be capable and useful members of their tribe. And so the story goes that the shrieks and cries that are heard late into the night are the ghosts of the drowned babies from the Pituit tribe. Another rendition of it is the fable that the Pituit tribesman and a mermaid from Pyramid Lake who fell madly in love only to have the union rejected from the tribe. The heartbroken mermaid was exiled from the lake by the Pituit tribe, but not only did she not leave, she remained there in her growing fury, cursing the waters and seeking vengeance on any man that attempts to enter her lake. This, of course, would explain all the missing fishermen. Now, some people believe that this story was concocted by the tribe to basically help salvage their name and repair it, and to cover up the actions of them drowning the babies. It's also known and said that if you hear the babies, you will have bad luck, but if you see them, you are dead. So that's basically all the facts. I want to know what you guys think. Do you guys really think that this lake is cursed? Do you really think Glee could be cursed? Do you think it's all just too many coincidences and science that are making people go missing? What are your thoughts? I love to hear your guys' opinions, and I hope you guys like this video, and I pray that they find her. I feel so bad for her son. That's so sad. And I'll definitely update you guys and let you know hopefully when they do find her, and I just hope that she's alive. Even though I have a really bad feeling that she's probably not, if they haven't found her yet. So I love you guys, and I'll see you soon. Bye.